Fuck is up? How are we? What is good, fam? Let's give ourselves a little bit of time. And we were doing English today. It is Tuesday. Give some time to Twitch. We have an official close on the prior candle, the prior month's candle. So looking at the dollar, we hit this 9. Usually these corrections are a little bit steeper, but look at the fucking buying power here. The bulls are in control. We just got a short pullback. I would have expected, just, you know, based on rules, to at least come back to this high, probably just under 100, and then wick up. We didn't even get there, guys. Dollar is killing it at a low of 101.2. We're at 106.5. Looking at this from a larger time frame. Oh, look who it is. How you doing, hon? I'm here talking about the markets because the crypto kind of fell out, but yeah. Anyway, so looking at this from a larger, from a higher time frame, we have another high that was around 2001, where we hit 120. And aside from that, it wasn't until the 80s where we saw anything above this. So, but we were hovering in this range for quite a while through the late 90s. But as you can tell, we're at historic highs, relatively speaking. We haven't really hit these levels since about 2002, so 2 decades ago, 20 years ago. And the dollar doesn't look like it's slowing down on a monthly chart. Looks like we're probably going to hit another little run here. So, and just to confirm on the lower level time frames, which are not as important, again, we had this 9 and on a 2 week and the monthly lining up. You'd think, especially after we just bursted through this quasi 9, that we would have hit a reversal there, but I guess not. Here, let me check the weekly for us and then I'll move on. Yeah, everything looks bullish as fuck for the dollar, guys. So, it does not look like it's slowing down on any time frame. All right, let's talk dollar versus the real. So, as expected, the real is actually weakening. We're almost at 5.4 reals or reais. Depends on where you are. Reais is Portuguese. But we're speaking English, so the real. After dropping down here to 4.6, we've had you covered. We got a nice W here. Once we broke this, boom. We bursted through these moving averages. Guys, I think we'll probably come back up to 5.6. And, you know, it would be almost common sense to think that we'll get rejected there again just because there's been so much pressure. Let's look at this from a higher level perspective. Should have started off on the monthly. Let's come back. Tartar! Yeikara! Beleza! Vai para el 14 sábado, né? Wow! Vai azar, né? Tamo juntos. Mas desculpa, Tartar. Hoje é inglês, eu sei. Meu português e meu inglês é similar, né? Alright, guys, gotta give a shout out. One of my favorite local DJs of this state in Brazil, Santa Catarina Tartar. Vamos! Cara, você tem uma pergunta sobre os mercados? Eu posso ver uma empresa do Brasil, qualquer coisa para você. Eu tô falando sobre a real contra o dólar agora. Anyway, let's continue this show here in English. All right, so hoping him and I get to create some nice nice piece of art for the people soon. So even on the monthly, yeah, it looks like, guys, we're starting a new trend upwards. If we look at this zooming out a bit, Once we broke these two highs in about January 2020, we really just took off through there. And this was pre-COVID. I really don't think this was affected by COVID as much. We found some, you know, we back tested a little bit here perfectly, super healthy pullback. But the fact that we're seeing this kind of price action just enveloping the prior candle here, I actually do think we at least hit 5.6, only a quick pullback. I don't think we're going to see under 5 for a little while, and then possibly higher, guys. Let's see. But this is not looking good for the real, and it is looking very good for the dollar. 2 week does not look like we're going to slow down. Weekly could kind of be slowing down slightly, but not really. I wouldn't change my opinion on it. And daily, like I said, looks good, guys. So, all right, Bitcoin, fucking boring as hell, hovering around 20K. Everybody knows that's the high from 2017. Makes perfect sense, historically speaking. Boom. A lot of people are calling for 14K. I've said it on this channel a few times. That 12 to 14K region probably gets tapped, especially because we're not seeing a really thorough rebound here. But I also have been saying, you know, statistically speaking, it's most likely we reverse once we get a red here. And to be honest with you, I think we need to suffer all throughout this month and the next month before we end up pulling a reversal. Yo, Justin, what's up, guy? How you doing, man? I'm talking to markets, doing some analysis on the price of Bitcoin. If you have any questions on a specific stock or coin or whatever you're into, man, let me know. Or if you have any questions about the music too. I've got some vocal packs coming out, doing a live show Saturday. Hope you're good, bro. All right, guys, coming back here. So yeah, I think we got another 2 months probably, because this month is just July, just started. Of suffering before, hopefully in the second half of the year, we see a massive rally. But a lot of institutional investment is going to be weary moving into the space, I think, for at least a year, maybe more, because of the Terra Luna fiasco, Three Arrows Capital, and they've gone bankrupt, and a lot of other major lenders. Voyage, fucking Digital Voyage, whatever the fuck they are. All these people, they lost a lot. They lost a lot. So I think we're going to need to see regulation before there's a new wave of institutional investment, to be honest, guys. So at least 2 more months. If we can hang out around 20K somehow and just be bored for 2 months, not making another low, which I don't think is likely, I'd put it at like 20% chance.
I won't expect a massive rally. I still have lots and lots of time.
Yeah, I agree. I think we need to have a nice slow bleed to the point where the market just gives up, gets frustrated, and that's when a new buying opportunity will. I mean, this is a buying opportunity, guys. You know, should be dollar costing averages at these prices for sure. But you know, I do think we go lower ultimately. Just because, again, without seeing any kind of slingshot effect here after such a dramatic fall, usually, you know, when this happens in the history of Bitcoin, the next month is just a rocket, and we see it's usually a minor dip, but the trend continues. This is the most prolonged bear market kind of territory, you know, consecutive down months we've seen since 2018. At least. So, let's check the bi-weekly here. Again, not much hope. Support is holding us here, this moving average. And I really do love the 2 week. If you've been watching the show, you know this. Look at nines, call it pretty accurately, which makes our lives easier. So, yeah, let's see. This could hold us, but I don't think it will. And weekly just looks like absolute shit. Looks so much, it looks even worse than the bi-weekly or the monthly. Broke this 200 200 period moving average, 200 week moving average. In this case, everybody's been talking about this. I'm sure we're aware. We do have, again, plenty of horizontal resistance here, support rather. But guys, once it breaks 12K, maybe a stop at 14, wick down to 12, something like that. Every 1,000 does get stronger, you know. It's a higher percentage of the overall value or price action. So we have that going for us. Daily here, yeah, you could say we didn't dip as low as we did here on these wicks, but candles closed almost right on the dot. So to me, unless we really have a nice close above 22K or something, there's just absolutely no reason to get excited here, guys. Absolutely no reason. And if we do break this, if we end up returning downwards and we break something like right here at like 19K, forget about it. Let me extend this a little bit here. All right. Let's see the fucking 12-hour. Doesn't look any fucking better. Who would have guessed it? 4-hour. Could see a little run here. I wouldn't bet the ranch on it, but 4-hour looks the most bullish out of all those charts. All right, Cam, what's up, bro? How you doing, man? I'm doing some analysis on the crypto markets. If you're into stocks, any particular cryptos that you haven't torn your eyes out yet for, then fucking let me know, and I'll do some price analysis for you, bro. Miss you, man. All right, monthly on Bitcoin dominance. I'm actually pretty surprised that last month we saw such a rally in the altcoins here. Coming down a little bit again, does surprise me. Let's see if we bounce off this looks better, I'm sure, on a different time scale, but if we bounce out of this, off of this arrow here and continue upwards. That's what I would expect. As I've said previously, in times of crisis, people usually retreat towards safer assets. And if you want to keep your money in crypto, it'd be silly to sell now. Bitcoin is the safest bet. So let's see. I'm going to just glance at this quickly, get to Frax. Obviously, I'll do ETH. I wouldn't really pay much attention to this. Maybe dominance rises after having, the second half of June was just straight down, so. Yeah, let's see. I'm pretty neutral on that. ETH looks shittier than Bitcoin, I think, to be honest. I think Bitcoin will probably correct before Ethereum, especially with this whole fucking rollout shit going on. These people don't know what they're doing. ETH is just a fucking slog. Too many people doing too many little, trying to make it do everything. It's going to end up being a centralized piece of shit as if it wasn't already. Yeah, guys, I'll be honest, I'm definitely bearish still overall on the market. ETH looks slightly worse than Bitcoin. I would personally like to have more of an allocation in Bitcoin, but I'm also a Bitcoin maximalist. Who knows? I could end up being, I always say when I'm more bullish ETH. I think if you go through my videos, I've been more bullish ETH looking at the charts objectively than Bitcoin on a number of episodes basis. But I personally, would prefer to hold Bitcoin. So Frax is so interesting to me because it always seems to rise while the market is dumping, and it's always doing the opposite of the market. When the market rises, it doesn't really rise. When the market dumps, it rises. So you can only imagine if it would rise with the market, the kind of levels we could hit. So this was pretty hard to trade usually this thing, you know, at least on the daily and weekly, follows the nines pretty easily. Here on the monthly, you can see this nice big rally. 27, that top of this wick has always historically, especially within the past 6 months, prior to the crash, been a strong level of support and resistance. We bursted through that, and this was right at the end of the year. We made up to like $45, almost 44, and right at the end of the year, Bitcoin just completely collapsed, and Frax was still rising, have a higher wick here, and then Bitcoin went, and then Frax shortly after just could not handle, you know, there was just too much profit to be had. Everybody kind of pulled out. I loved how these wicks were rising, though. And then once we hit, what did we hit again here? 43 again. Usually when you hit an all-time high like that, you either just have a quick pullback and then higher. I was not expecting such a dramatic turn here. Because in April, once it did look like the next month in May, we would rocket off of this diagonal here. We ended up not, because of the whole Luna fiasco in May, early May. Obviously, Luna, Terra imploded. And because of that, we have this giant red fucking candle where we went down 68%. And the following month, June, was not very pretty either, down another 36%. And we're up 10% since the beginning of, really, honestly, this is just a rise today because we pumped today. 2 week. So, I mean, guys, I actually, if I was going to say something bold that I wouldn't, you know, I don't want to, I don't want anybody taking bets, you know, on this necessarily, but I'll be honest, I think there's at least a chance we've already seen the bottom in Frax. As long as we don't see a 14K Bitcoin before we see like an $11 Frax. If we can get like $11, $13, $14 Frax, and then we go down to 14K, the low will still be in. But if we end up hitting 14K in the next month or two before Frax rallies, and Frax can rally in a week or two, guys, but if that happens, 14K Bitcoin happens before we rally, yes, maybe we can go lower. But Frax has been defending that $4.50 to $5 range quite well. So, not the time to sell, in my opinion. We're finally seeing a little bit of life here. Bounced off this perfectly, guys. I drew these lines ages ago. You can look at my past videos. And let's see if we can continue this little run, guys. You know, a close above like $6. You know, this thing can go up. I'd be investing in Frax right now. I would. Oh my God, just so much blood. But that's fine. When there's blood in the streets, it's when you chuck some cash out there into the market. You gotta invest when nobody else wants to and sell when nobody else wants to. You gotta go contrary to, you gotta swim upstream, you know? You gotta be that salmon fighting for his life, going against the grain. So, S&P is doing okay. This has been a pretty serious correction. Really, since the beginning of the year, it's just been straight down. What was that? March was good, yeah. But that's been really it. As far as where we end up, I don't think we end up breaking like 3,400, to be honest with you. Like 3,300 would be like probably the low for me. And we might even have a little bit of a rally before that. We'll see how the macro economy looks. MicroStrategy is obviously getting fucking hammered. They were up at $900, had a high of like, what, 1,300? Yeah. So, ASTS. I always look at ASTS for my friends in the group. Let's see what we got here. Monthly. You're glad that, you know, to see a little bit of life here in this month, but this isn't telling me anything. We'd have to either close below these to see an even more dramatic drop. And, you know, when you're seeing a lot of these tech stocks, you know, see negative 80% on Netflix or whatever. These things are down. And exploring outer space and improving this type of technology, what is this, like satellite shit or something, that stuff gets ignored, let's say, you know, as people focus on commodities and things that are a little bit more, you know, safe in this type of micro economic environment. 2 week again, kind of telling me the same thing, which is not much. Weekly, same thing. Dude, total no trade zone for me here. Yeah, just not worth the risk or reward either way. And yeah, I that's how I feel. I would not trade. I would not set up a trade for that. Oh my god. Coinbase on the 4 hour nine, nice little reversal today. But honestly, Jesus, look at these fucking bastards. Coinbase just, like a whole report came out saying that they sold customer data to the authorities, the U.S. authorities, and when I was seeing the price tag, it was like 50 grand. It was insane. I'm sure that they were just lucky to even get that. That was probably to help them, you know, staff someone to implement whatever the fuck they needed to, whatever API calls, database integration bullshit they made them do. You know, of course they have them by the balls, you know, trying to avoid money laundering and, you know, get their tax money. Biden increased the number of workers employed by the IRS by like 4x this year or something, or up like, I think it was, I don't want to get the stat wrong, you know, please excuse me. I think it was, he added 400 people. There was a 4 in there. And I know that 400% and 400 people could be very different numbers, but I do believe it was something outrageous. Maybe I'll look that up at the end. I don't want to make any political kind of comments at this time. But so yeah, Coinbase could be seeing a little bit of a revival. I don't know how much lower it could go, but I mean, again, with the Bitcoin price of Bitcoin possibly going to 14K, I wouldn't be buying right now. But again, if you're only in traditional markets and you do want some exposure to Bitcoin, this does look like a depends like. I'd have to see a close above like probably $70 for me to really feel good about it. But some people have more risk tolerance. With all these lows here, yeah, this is a great day, and this does look like a little reversal here. But if you are going to see a rally, I would need more of a confirmation here, because we could just have 2-3 bad days, lower high, and once this level of support's broken here, like $45. You could really see this thing crash to maybe nothing. So not nothing, but you know, that's what it'll feel like. Again, shout out to Oexagon Labs. Oh, come on guys. There we go. Buddy of mine creating this, working on, he's using some kind of quantum algorithms to create this thing. It's the first of its kind. Yes, true quantum randomness, because decide the quantity of traits and its rarity level. Holders of her will be granted the status of membership as well. Nice. Check it out, guys. Man, yeah, I just had to give my boy Guillermo a little shout out. What else, guys? I know I'm behind on a couple of the Portuguese episodes. I promise to get back on those. Yeah, MTV, baby. I talked about inflation the other night. I'm gonna end up posting that one tomorrow. It is in Portuguese, but I'll talk about it real quick. It was pretty basic stuff, you know. But Brazil, like the government's quick to fucking lock these people's, freeze these accounts of these people. Beleza, Bruno. So yeah, amanhã português, caras, mesmo tempo, 21 horas. Fucking check it. Let's see if I have any questions over here. No, it doesn't look like it. Yay, Lucas. What's going on, Lucas? Man, got some people joining. You gotta turn in this bitch up. Oh my god. Salve. hablo, voy a hablar. Inglés, Portugués, Español. Entonces, no, es muy difícil esos días con criptomonedas, es tiempo para enfocar en otras cosas, ¿sabe? Y tal vez un art o ganando dólares para comprar más criptomonedas. Y siempre precisamos, necesitamos español ahora para ti. Para usted. Pero sí. Necesitamos enfocar en nuestros lanzamientos, en las otras cosas a veces cuando no estamos con mucha suerte en los mercados. Y necesitamos agradecer, apreciar y estar grato para que tenemos. Y la vida es muy linda en todos los jeitos. Solo precisamos ver como tanto bonita una cosa es da la perspectiva de la persona viendo. Entonces, necesitamos ficar positivo durante esos tiempos, amigos. Habla con sus otros amigos para saber que todo el mundo está positivo todavía, porque es muy estresante, Si tú tienes una otra pregunta, amigo, me hablo. Yo puedo hablar sobre la vida, sobre la economía, sobre filosofías. Yo soy un utilitario. I'm a utilitarian for anyone speaking English still listening. It means I believe in maximizing the most amount of happiness for the most amount of people. And I try to do so as efficiently as possible. And as altruistic of a way as possible as I can here. I'd say that should be our focus, but more importantly is getting our values aligned. And a lot of these societies that are overly focused on, you know, just the bank account, sometimes they miss the sweeter things in life. And as Ferris would say, you know, life will pass you by if you don't stop to look around once in a while. So I know that I've become much more grateful for the people that, you know, gave me courage and support me during this brutal fucking stretch here in crypto. So anyway, guys, music is coming, guys. I've got another recording session tomorrow. I've got a ton of shit that's gonna come out. I just gotta like master it all at once. I have a great friend who kicks ass at it. I've been trying to set some stuff up with. So anyway, I think I'll call it here. I'm at like 35 minutes already. But keep it real, homies. Fucking stay real. And there will be better days ahead. Keep your head up. And again, I hope I get some more questions about things other than, you know, fucking business and the economy in these next shows, because I got a fucking world to talk about. And would love to spread knowledge on whatever subject interests the fucking people. Dude knows, motherfuckers. Get educated. Spread love. One love. Alright, peace out, peace out. Ah, Jesus Christ, you know. I usually fuck around a little bit in the beginning and the end on these Twitch ones, but I'm gonna have to use this one as my... I didn't hit start fucking recording over here, so the Twitch video will go up live. That'll be how I record it. So anyway, if you stuck around, thanks. One love. And yeah, keep it real until the next one. 8 o'clock Eastern next Tuesday. Peace out, fam.